Good evening to all. Welcome, dear student, to the world of pharmacognosy. Today, we are going to study new chapter, that is marine pharmacognosy, from unit 5 of 4th semester syllabus of pharmacognosy and phytochemistry subject of second year B.Pharm. In this lecture, we have been covering some important points from chapter marine pharmacognosy. In that, we cover definition of marine pharmacognosy, challenges behind the pharmacognosy, significance of marine pharmacognosy, and classification of marine drugs with their respective examples. Let's start with definition of marine pharmacognosy. It is defined as to acquire knowledge of natural drugs of marine origin, means to acquire knowledge of natural drugs which are marine in origin. It can also be defined as it is sub-branch of pharmacognosy, which is mainly concerned with naturally occurring substances of medicinal importance from marine sources. Challenges behind the marine pharmacognosy. Challenges are, there are many problems associated with collecting marine drugs. Not a uniform source, toxicity, diverse knowledge of plant and animal. The challenges are due to, as marine organisms are present in ocean or sea, it is difficult to collect and use them as it is. Also, the marine organisms does not act as a uniform source for marine drug, as their presence in ocean is get varied. There are many marine organisms which are highly toxic in nature, which are toxic to the human. Also, one who are working in the era of marine drug or marine microorganisms should have greater knowledge or should have diverse knowledge of plant and animals of marine pharmacognosy. Now, what is significance of marine pharmacognosy? Marine organisms are potential source of drug discovery. We can use marine organism for drug discovery as a big source. Earth constitutes about 70% of water, which covers ocean and seas, which contributes biological ecological diversity ranging from microorganisms to vertebrates. Microorganisms are a rich source of structurally diverse bioactive compounds. Marine products offers abundant source of pharmacologically active drugs with their greater therapeutic actions. As we know that Earth is covered by 70% of water and it has huge variety of life, means it contains different kind of microorganisms and vertebrates, which contributes as a big or abundant source of marine drugs. Also, the sea and ocean has biodiversity, that is presence of different biological organism inside it. So it has different structural biological active compounds. Marine product offers abundant source of pharmacologically active drugs and it exerts pharmacological actions or therapeutic actions. Then classification of marine drugs with their examples. There are different class of marine drugs. The first class is antibiotics. The example is cyclo-eudismol. Second class is anti-inflammatory and antispasmodic agent. Examples: manoalide, tetrodotoxin, Antimicrobial compound contains halotoxin ABC, thalapine, unicin, acanthaline. Cardiovascular substances consist of anthopleurines, laminin, iptatetrine, saxitoxin, cytotoxic compounds. Examples: RAS-C, crassin acetate, simularin, marine toxin. Contains cigotoxin, palytoxin, saxitoxin, brevitoxin. And last class of marine drug is miscellaneous compounds. Contains caenic acid, domoic acid, aplysinopsin. Let's start with first class antibiotics. There is a broad classification of marine antibiotics with their marine organism is listed here. The marine organism Pseudomonas bromutilis. Pseudomonas bromutilis is a marine bacterium from which we can obtain antibiotics such as 2,4-dibromo-6-3,4,5-tribromopyrrol-2-ylphenol. Second marine organism is Chondria oppositi clada. It is a red algae from which we can obtain cycloeudismol as an antibiotic. Third marine organism is Yersinia strobilina and Yersinia oros, which is a sponge which gives variabilin and irisin 1 as a antibiotics. Next is Veirongia arkiri is an marine organism. It is also a sponge from which 3,5-dibromo-4-hydroxybenzene-1-acetamide is obtained. Next class of marine drug is anti-inflammatory and anti-spasmodic agents. Here also there are some marine microorganisms given and from which the anti-inflammatory and anti-spasmodic drugs obtained are listed below. First anti-inflammatory drug is manoalide. It is a non-steroidal anti-inflammatory compound, has been obtained from sponge Leucopharilla variabilis. Probably it act by direct inactivation of phospholipase A2, which is an enzyme present in some neurotoxin and also has a role in synthesis of prostaglandins in human. Manoalide has analgesic and selective anti-inflammatory properties. The other anti-inflammatory agent reported are dandrolone 3-hydroxybutyrate from a sponge Phyllospongia dendil. Next, flexibilide from a soft coral Cyanularia flexibilis and is chemically diterpenoid semrane. Next, The muscle relaxant action is associated with flustramine A and B, which are present in Flustra foliacea, a Swedish marine moss. Next is tetradoxin, obtained from liver and ovaries of puffer fishes, is a strong antispasmodic agent. Next, antimicrobial compounds. A large number of antimicrobial compounds have been detected from marine organisms like sea cucumber, marine algae, sponges, sea hare, gorgonian corals, and red algae. The organisms and their antimicrobial principles are listed below. Sea cucumber, that is Stychopus japonicum, from which we can obtain halotoxin A, B, and C, which is antifungal in nature, and xanthoral and isoxanthoral. Brown algae, that is Dictyopterid zonaroids, from which we can obtain tetrabromoheptanone as an antimicrobial compound. Red algae, Bone Masonia, Hemifera, from which we can obtain 4 isomers of polyhalo-3-butene, 2, 1, and 7 isomers of polyethyloacetone. Then, red algae, Asparagopsis taxiformis, from which we can obtain aeroplycinin 1, Verongenia aerophoba, from which we can obtain aeroplycinin 1, Aegilus oroids, from which we can obtain 2-cyano-4,5-dibromopyrrol. Pripassi phenol is obtained from red algae Lauraceae pacifica L. Tholpin is obtained from Annelida, that is marine organism Thalepsis sitosus, and sea hare Aplysia californica, from which we can obtain dibromolaurenterol as an antimicrobial compound. Eunicin is obtained from gorgonian corals Eucinia mammosa, and from Acanthellia acuta we can obtain acanthellin 1, which is active against Mycobacterium. Cardiovascular active substances. The marine microorganism Anthopleura xanthogrammica and Anthopleura elegantissima, from which we can obtain anthopleurins type A and B and type C respectively. Next serious active substance is iptatetrin. It is found in a neural bronchial herds of Pacific hogfish, that is Iptatetrus stouti. It is a potent cardiac stimulant with direct stimulant action on mammalian myocardium, which is a comparable to adrenaline. Laminin, a marine algae Laminaria angustata, gives these basic amino acid compounds with hypotensive effects. Octopamine It produces adrenergic and cardiovascular response, and it's found in octopus, macropus, octopus vulgaris. Next, saxitoxin. It shows a hypotensive effect and is found in butter calm, that is Saxidomus giganteus and California mussels. Next, autonomium. This compound has isosteric structure of adrenaline and acetylcholine and is found in Veronica fistularis. It produces both alpha and beta adrenergic effects and also exhibit cholinergic activity. Sea anemone, Condylactis and Gigantea, from which we can obtain ATX second and anthoblurines. Sea cucumber, from which we can obtain halothurins and osterosaponins. Spongocene is obtained from Cryptothethia crypta, and Illidocene is obtained from the Illidocene moschata. Cytotoxic or anti-cancer compound. ARA-C, it is 1-alpha-D, arabinofuranosyl cytosine or cytosine arabinoside. It is obtained as a synthetic compound based on the knowledge of naturally occurring moieties present in carabinan sponge, that is spongocene and spongouridine. It is used in treatment of acute myelogenous leukemia and human acute leukemia for therapeutic purpose. Next, crassine acetate. It is a member of sembranoids, which are cyclic diterpene obtained from soft corals. Crassine acetate is obtained from Caribbean gorgonian pseudoplexura porosa, which is cytotoxic to human leukemia and HeLa cells in vitro. Next, aplicistatin. It is an anti-leukemic from sea hare, that is Aplysia angasi, and the majusculamine C is obtained from algae, that is Lingbia majuscula. Marine troxin. Gambier discus toxicus, from which we can obtain marine toxin, cigotoxin, which is present in red trial dinoflagellate Gambier discus toxicus. The term cigotoxin was first used to describe an element associated with ingestion of marine snails. The next, palytoxin. It is a long chain polyhydroxy macromolecule present in Palytoa species and is most potent coronary vasoconstrictor. Retide toxin. This is obtained from Guanulax catenella, a marine organism. Miscellaneous compound. Miscellaneous compound. Canic acid is a potent convulsant, has been isolated from red algae, that is Digenia simplex, which shows anti ascaritic activity. Also, domoic acid has been found in red algae Chondria ermata with activity against ascaris and pinworm. A marine annelid, Lumriconeris heteropoda, gives Neris toxin, found to be useful as an insecticide due to its ganglion blocking effect. Next, Diadems ABC have protective action against herpes simplex type 2 virus in mice. Yellow sponge, Veirongia spengeli, gives aplysinopsin, which has antidepressant action in animals and also cytotoxic activity. Last, acanthifolicin, a polyether antibiotic found in a sponge Pandarus acanthifolium, which also possesses cytotoxic activity. This is all about marine pharmacognosy, classification of marine drug with their examples, definition, challenges and significance of marine pharmacognosy. Thank you for watching.